What we are asked to do is find out how far this ship is from port to where it is now. So that's the line right there called a D. So let's go through it one more time. We have north vertically that way. The ship travels 17 kilometers north and then easterly, which is at right angles to the right, that way for a certain direction, but we don't know. And we don't need to know. What we do need to know is the bearing is 48. It went north 17 kilometers. Our mission and our objective is to find this distance here, right there. Now, as you look at this diagram, I wonder whether you can notice something familiar. You probably notice that we have a right angle right over there. We have a straight length here and another straight length connected to that right angle. And we have this long length here that we're looking for. Now that D kind of looks like a hypotenuse, doesn't it? So we can use some effective trigonometry here. So here's the angle or the bearing that we have. How about we use this angle? We use this side and we find out what that hypotenuse is. So the decision now is, let's work out what ratio it is. Is it a sine? Is it a cos? Or is it a tan? Well, let's find out now by pointing it all out. Well, here's the angle, 48 degrees. Now to its left, or right next to it, we have 17 kilometers. Now, because it's next to it, it's going to be what? It's going to be ADJ. It's adjacent, isn't it? ADJ over there, adjacent. And over here to the right, the long length obviously is the hypotenuse, yeah? Okay, let's write this in now that we have the trig ratio. So it looks like it's adjacent over hypotenuse, and what is that? That's going to be a cos, yeah? So it's a cos angle. So we're going to write down cos, and the angle here, of course, or the bearing to the right is 48 degrees. Let's write that in. And that equals adjacent, which is how many kilometers north? 17. Let's write that in. 17 kilometers all over. Now what we're looking for is the D across there, and that's the hypotenuse, so let's put that in. There's our D. Terrific. Now we are looking for D, that's the missing pronumeral. So like the regular trigonometry we've done in the past, let's swap the D with the cos 48. We can do that, or if you prefer, you can cross multiply. Or another way of saying the same thing is multiply both sides by D. So I'm just going to swap them for speed. Let's swap them. And what we can say is now the D over there, D equals, we keep the 17. D equals 17 all over, and bring the cos 48 to the denominator underneath. Let me write that underneath. Cos 48 degrees. There we have a very effective equation. We're looking for D, the hypotenuse. Let's find out the distance that the ship is from P, the port. Okay, on our calculator, let's go 17 divided by cos 48. The answer will be D equals 25.46 kilometers. Now you will notice in the question it states to the nearest kilometer. So because it's a 0.4, 0.4 goes downwards. So therefore to the nearest kilometer, the ship from port to where it is now, the distance is
take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.